Discover the nature of your universe at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History.
There's so much here, but I want to focus today on a great exhibit that's just up that celebrates both the legacy and the future of the CIA. And to help me describe this exhibit, we have Julie Lansom and Bruce Chachevsky. Welcome.
It's so great to be here.
Tell me about this exhibit.
Well, it's called From Here to Infinity and the Big Bang. Bruce curated From Here to Infinity, and I curated the Big Bang, which it describes our artists that have recently graduated from the Institute from 1996 to 2006. And we're just so proud of these students. They've just sort of exploded into the art scene, both in New York and in Cleveland.
Give me an example of the range of endeavors that they've gone on to after they've left CIA.
Well, they've gotten gallery representation, they've had exhibits, they are being written about in Art Forum and Art in America. They are employed, they have jobs, they're making livings in a city like New York, which is so expensive and so difficult. Some of them that are living in Cleveland have opened galleries here in Cleveland and are sort of making this city a very vital and important place for artists to be and to live. And it's just really exciting to see how well they're doing and how important they're making the art world.
And some of these people were your students. You're the head of painting now, and you're watching them move out into the world.
It's really exciting. It's like, you know, spawning this whole new generation of artists, and it's really exciting that they are coming from the Cleveland Institute of Art. A lot of them are going on to really prominent graduate schools, Yale University, Columbia, Hunter College, and it's very exciting that Cleveland is the spot and this nexus where this is all happening.
That's wonderful. That's great. I'm glad you're doing this exhibit. As important as it is to look at the future of the CIA, it's also fundamental to look at the past. Bruce, could you give me an overview of the show and how it reflects the history of the CIA?
Let's talk about the legacy for a second. Every American in this country has touched something that's been either designed or made by Victor Schreckengoss or one of his students. Victor was the founder of the Industrial Design Department here at the Institute in the 1930s, and it was really the founder of the industrial design movement in America. It's a phenomenal achievement. You'll also find works by Robert Mangold, who is an important figure in the minimalist movement in the 1970s. Works by Dana Schutz, who's the most recent graduate, 2000, who's doing extraordinary work in the field of painting, and is one of Julie's students. In a part of the exhibition, you'll see Ed Mitchkowski and Julian Stanzak and Richard Aniskevich were the founders of the OP movement in the 1960s. The Museum of Modern Art in 1965 had a very important exhibition called the Responsive Eye. And this was the beginning of the OP art movement. OP art is optical art that has some kind of physical effect on your eye. Most notably in the 1960s, it's kind of like a psychedelic, kind of been morphed into the psychedelic design and culture. There's also Mark Brown, who created Arthur the Art Park that graces PBS every day.
You mentioned Mark Brown, creator of Arthur. What's the earliest artist represented in the show?
There are several extraordinary Charles Birchfield paintings from 1970, and Charles Birchfield is considered by many to be the most important watercolors of the 20th century. And those works we have in the exhibition are as vibrant now as they were when they were painted in 1917.
So in the end, what does this tell us about the impact of the CIA?
You will find in every major museum in the country a work by a Cleveland Institute of Art student. Every regional museum in the country has something that's been made by a Cleveland Institute of Art student. It's a phenomenal achievement.
Well, thank you very much for being here, both of you, and describing your show.
Bringing Northern Ohio to your door every month, Northern Ohio Live Magazine's proud to support Live from the Circle. Dining, theater, basically all that's unique to our region can be found on NorthernOhioLive.com. Arts, culture, and living. Northern Ohio Live.